No wonder Amaru had it so well guarded. This is Sairi's tomb. There's an inscription in Latin. I will never hesitate again. I wonder what that means. There's also a key. All right, let's try red in the north. Dancing Tree Water 9. It also means many. Dancing water near many trees. I think I know what fits that description. I don't have enough space for that. This key was interred with Sairi's body, which means Amaru put it here. Was he trying to keep it preserved or keep it hidden? Probably both. There's a Mayan symbol on it, similar to the ones on the cipher wheel, representing north. All full up. Can't carry anymore.
Careful.
progress. Rotten food. From Trinity. How did they find this cave? The key fits this chest. Maybe the answers are inside. Sairi, here is some food to begin distributing to our people. I wish I'd managed to obtain it sooner, before you went hunting, especially since, as your older brother, the responsibility was mine, not yours. But you have always been as stubborn as the rest of our family. It comes from Trinity, that secret group of outsiders I was telling you about. They promised me more, but first there is something I have to do for them. You can find me at the old village, beyond the gate that was put up to protect people from the red fungus. Amaru. Whatever the secret of this cipher wheel is, I don't think it has to do with the current conflict. I think it's older and much more personal. With luck, I'll find the explanation in the old village. Full up. Can't carry any more. All full up. Can't carry any more. We found their hidden city easily enough, the coordinates from Trinity being correct. The natives did not trust us, and we entered the city with spears at our necks. There was a tumult against the people. We later learned a cohort of Inca had arrived the month before. Lopez spun a tale of our desertion from the Spanish army, for our hearts could not fathom the destruction they had and would continue to cause, and we'd gladly exchange any or all of our goods for shelter, if only for a short while. Reluctantly, they allowed us to remain in the city, on the condition we leave our armor and weapons in a small hut outside of the city proper. The men hesitated, and finally we agreed that two of us would remain outside, guarding the gear. I don't have enough space for that. Location found, hidden, terrain difficult to traverse. Seems safe from the strangers intent on forcing us into slavery. Space for that. This must be the red fungus Amaru mentioned in his letter. It's obviously deadly. Trinity must have put these here. I should still be functional. My dearest Sairi, I am leaving this for you here at the gateway to my greatest fear, in case I do not return. Trinity have, on more than one occasion, offered me the opportunity to join their number, and for several reasons I've delayed giving them a final answer. But I can delay no longer. They can provide the resources we need to feed Paititi and rescue our city from this terrible famine. So I put my fears aside, willing to risk even my very life for our people. And if I should pay the ultimate price, know that I did so with pride and with no regrets. Your loving brother, always, Amaru. The gate wasn't just for protection. It was to hide this tomb, and Amaru knew it was here. Walls are too deadly to cross, but I can't pry my way through that barrier. Full up. Can't carry anymore. full up. Can't carry any more. I don't have enough space for that. So many bodies. I have to avoid those spores. As anticipated, Amaru has completed the sixth seal in exemplary fashion. In fact, he has earned the highest recorded score in the history of this trial, a testament not only to his considerable skill, but to his formidable determination. I judge him to be a more than worthy successor to my position. Signed, Dr. Dominguez. It's not a name. It's the title given to Trinity's leader. P.S. We will at once provide Paititi with the food necessary to relieve the famine, as promised to Amaru in exchange for committing to our cause.